Despite all the smoke and flames, officials still say the air remains safe around the Intercontinental Terminals Company facility.
It's a story that we've been following since yesterday morning. We have team coverage of the latest developments. Channel 2 investigator Joel Eisenbaum is digging deeper into the transparency from the officials. But we begin with Robert Arnold, who is live in Deer Park with the latest developments now. Robert.
We're about a quarter mile from 225, and these clouds of smoke have shown no signs of slowing down. In fact, somebody we spoke to who lives in southeast Houston said when they woke up this morning, they thought rain clouds were moving in, then saw the news reports that the fire was still burning at ITC. We just spoke with ITC officials, and they say they are battling fire at six different tanks. You'll notice that the number of tanks has come down slightly. ITC officials saying that one tank they now know is empty. Another tank, they said that there was a quick flare up, but that tank is not actually on fire. So they are battling fire at six different tanks. And we did get the chance to get an update from ITC officials on their firefighting efforts.
We have made some headway in that three of our tanks are still on fire and three are in intermittent fires. So they flare up and then they go down.
Now, plant officials still have not given us an exact list of exactly everything that may be going into the air. The only thing we've seen by way of that is something called an air emission event report. Now, companies like ITC will file this report with the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality in the initial stages of an emergency. It is just an estimate. And what we saw on that report was the company estimating that carbon monoxide, some naphtha, and a little bit of nitrogen oxide going into the air. But again, I want to caution, these are estimates right now, and this report will almost certainly change in some form or fashion after the fire is out and the investigations are complete. On that report, there's also a line for cause, and the only thing listed there was a leak in a tank manifold being ignited, but no other specifics were given. Now, as you've heard from Harris County officials as well as plant officials, they've been doing air quality monitoring at several different spots from here all the way into the Houston area, and so far have not found any dangerous readings of anything in any of the neighborhoods following along that plume of smoke. In fact, the company just released a report from a third-party company that it has brought in to monitor air quality. And again, it says so far they have not found any dangerous chemicals in the neighborhood. I should point out, though, that third-party company's report, their reporting period ended at 7:42 this morning. So we're seeing if we can get some updated numbers for you. As soon as we do, we will pass those along. Reporting live from Deer Park, Robert Arnold, KPRC, Channel 2 News.